With cable and satellite bills higher than ever in 2018, streaming TV sounds more and more attractive every day. But you know, it can be confusing with so many options. So we wanted to update our streaming showdown from earlier this spring to help you decide which service is best.
Emily Wilder is a mom of a one-year-old girl.
Don't climb on it, silly.
With money tight in her Eastgate home, her cable bill was too much.
Cable was just getting so expensive. It was $150 a month.
So she cut the cord, paying for just internet, Netflix, and Hulu. As for that $150 cable bill?
How much do you pay per month?
$55.
Rocco Newby has also dropped his cable package in his Butler County home.
And when I got the $170, it was just ridiculous to pay that much money for cable service when you hardly only watch just a couple channels.
Now he uses an Amazon Fire Stick and an antenna to pick up local channels so he can watch the Nine on Your Side news team.
So I cut it, and I got used to watching TV over the air and in streaming.
Rocco's savings?
It's, you know, $1,000 a year. I'll be glad to put that in my pocket.
So which service is best for you? Well, it all depends whether you're a big fan of news or sports or lifestyle shows and movies, because each service has its own specialty.
First, you'll need high-speed internet, $30 to $60 a month. Then you'll need a device like a smart TV, Roku box, Apple TV, Google Chromecast, or Amazon Fire Stick. Now you're ready.
99.9% of people can find a perfect streaming solution, I think.
Alex Haslam with CutCableToday.com has compared the five main players. Sling TV is cheapest, $20 a month, but has a limited channel lineup. DirecTV Now is $35 a month, and with 60 channels is most like a cable package. PlayStation View is $40 a month, and Alex says has the best video quality. A big misconception.
You don't need a PlayStation to stream it on, which I think a lot of people are confused by.
Hulu Live, also $40 a month, has the most sports channels. YouTube TV is $35 a month and offers local channels. Amazon Prime is not quite a full service option yet, but it's coming. She cautions that some services have ESPN, some don't. Some have HGTV, some don't. Some are missing CNN or Fox News. It sounds tricky, but Emily says with a smart TV, streaming is no longer complicated.
All I have to do is hit menu, and the apps are already loaded on there for me.
You know, new streaming services are popping up every month. Fubo and Crackle and others aim at niche audiences like sports fanatics or gamers. Just make sure the service you choose has the channels you want so you don't waste your money. I'm John Matarese, 9 on Your Side.